हेलो हेलो हाय, आई एम बैजू गोविंदन एंड आई एम द को फाउंडर ऑफ काइनेसिस। काइनेसिस कम्युनिकेशंस इज़ अ नीश पब्लिक रिलेशंस फर्म विच हैज़ बीन फंक्शनल अक्रॉस द कंट्री फॉर मोर देन 5 ईयर्स। मोर इम्पोर्टेंटली, वी हैंडल पब्लिक रिलेशंस फॉर कैलोरिक्स ग्रुप अमंगस्ट अ लॉट ऑफ अदर प्रेस्टिजियस क्लाइंट्स। याली हो टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स एंड पेरेंट्स एंड स्टाफ मेंबर्स ऑफ DPS ईस्ट स्कूल। सो लेट मी गिव यू अ वेरी ब्रीफ पर्सनल इंट्रोडक्शन। आई हैव अ क्यूमुलेटिव एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ अबाउट 15 odd years, having worked in journalism, in advertising, as a copywriter, and as a PR professional. So today, when we talk about the subject of careers in media and communication, let us first try and understand what is communication. Communication is the sharing of information or transmission of knowledge. Now, how does this sharing or flow of information take place? So, to try and understand a flow chart of how the process of communication takes place, it begins first with thought. When you feel, when you perceive, when you think about a subject, thought gives rise to an idea. Right. An idea is a coupling of words. Narendra Modi is a good prime minister. Right. It forms an idea. Narendra Modi represents a word, represents a particular concept. A good prime minister, and a good one at that, forms an entire idea. So the first comes thought, then comes idea. The idea has to be expressed, and the expression of this idea leads to a perception. The moment I make a statement that Narendra Modi is a good prime minister, people might agree to it, counter it, and more importantly, have a form a visual imagery of it. Right. So, if you notice in the entire flow chart of communication, words are the building block of all communication. The converse of this flow chart is also true. First, you can have visual imagery, perception, then expression, the formation of an idea, and it occurs into a thought. And which is why the flow chart or the equation of communication is retroversible, the converse of which is also true. The most important aspect of this entire communication structure is that every communication is essentially an attempt to sell. Now, what does this structure of communication attempt to sell? Come to think of it, whether you asked for breakfast from your mother today, you communicated with your teachers, the teachers trying to explain something to you online in your classes, every attempt is, if I dare say, it is an attempt, every attempt at communication is an attempt to sell. Now, sell what? An individual, a concept, an organization, a product, a service, an experience, a narrative. Now, this is an overview of the communication industry. Now, what are the typologies of communication? There are four broad typologies of communication. One is the written word. What you read in newspapers, what you read online, what you read on your social media, earths. The second is visuals, which include photos, videos, graphics, animation. The third is audio, pure audio, which could include radio, music, podcasts. And the fourth is events and activations, which is creating an experience. Now, what are the professional disciplines in communication? One is journalism, which could be print, video, or web. The second would be advertising and branding. Third is digital media marketing. Fourth is events and activation. Fifth is public relations. Sixth is radio and digital podcasts. The sixth is films and programming. This is how we essentially consume communication in this golden age of communication. The last two decades have been called the golden age of communication. It is the era of communication, right? The world's been made a smaller place. We are able to connect much faster than ever before. And every business, every endeavor of the human race is now made better, is enhanced by this discipline of communication. Now, to understand this, broadly, what are the professional qualifications required for someone to pursue a career in media and communication? There are undergraduate and postgraduate courses, which are degrees in journalism and mass communication, and there are degrees in photography and filmmaking. The most important thing to understand is that, unlike most professional disciplines, media and communications is academically agnostic, which means these professions are essentially skill based. The biggest professionals in this field are not qualified in communications. They have studied other subjects as their core qualification, but joined this field because of one single word, which is flair. Flair is the most important aspect of becoming a good communicator. Now, let us look at how does each professional discipline in communication pan out as a professional career. To talk about journalism,